And another thing, Master. Have you caught the villain who wanted to kill me?
No, I haven't. I didn't catch the villain who wanted to kill you. He got away between the brush and the steep twists of the path.
But why?
I don't know. Not yet, I don't. But I suspect we'll find out soon enough. Fair enough. It's late. Let's head for the Abbey. These gates guard one of the most eminent and enigmatic abbeys in the kingdom. The impregnability of its library is legendary, both for those who might seek to destroy it and for those who merely wish to study it. There surely must be a more efficient system of knocking than having to bash against this massive door, which is twice our size. That's the bell which announces to the brother acting as gatekeeper that someone is waiting outside the door. I can't reach it from here. Perhaps if I were able to climb up onto something. This rope is attached to the bell.
We have been impatiently awaiting your arrival, Brother Leonardo.
I sincerely regret the delay, brother.
It's all the same to me. I have explicit orders from the abbot to wait at the gate to welcome you, even if that means spending the whole time out here on a devilish night like this.
We had a little accident.
The path is filled with danger, brother. Not only due to the difficult lay of the land, but because on nights like these, robbers and thieves have the perfect conditions to commit their evil deeds.
Take a good look at us, brother.
Equidio.
What loot could they hope for from poor monks like us?
The horse and the donkey.
Did anyone leave the abbey last night?
The compline prayers are already over with and everyone's asleep, brother. You'll notice during your stay just how strict the schedule is at our abbey. Come in, come in. I'll take you to your cell so that you can lie down. You can see the abbot tomorrow.
Brother Leonardo, it is an honor for this humble abbey to be allowed to welcome you.
Father Abbot, if the honor is as great as your modesty, I don't think I deserve it. This is Bruno, the son of the Count of Capra Negra.
Where were we? Ah, yes, the young man who would like to be initiated into our abbey.
Father?
We have brought a gift from the Count. A gift? What is it? What is it?
A book that shows the Count's interest in...
No, a book. I think I get the point. He's very interested in seeing his son have a successful career with the church.
Father, these days a book can be a great treasure.
Brother Leonardo, as with many others, news of your wisdom and perception has reached my ears as well. As there is a matter which does worry me, I would very much like to discuss it with you.
Does that have something to do with the demise of your former gatekeeper?
But how?
I just spied Egidius walking towards the cemetery with a wooden cross on a cart. I put two and two together and deduced that a monk must have died recently. And as Egidius was the one who waited for us last night, and the duties of a gatekeeper normally have nothing to do with those of a gravedigger, it's only logical that the deceased must be the gatekeeper.
But why do you suspect that something curious is attached to that death?
An accident wouldn't make you uneasy. And if the situation dealt with a suicide, you wouldn't bury him in consecrated soil.
Impressive!
Although, that's not all you should be worried about.
What do you mean by that?
Yesterday we were attacked by a monk, and there aren't too many monasteries around here.
I regret any such incident. But I'm sure that your eyes and the dearth of light caused illusions that deceived you. Once the prayers for compline have been said, The monks are not allowed to leave the abbey.
Is that right?
All of the doors are locked tight, and the only ones who don't sleep in the artificium, where the monks' cells are the brother gatekeeper and myself.
Fair enough, but I'll still be on my guard. Rather than finding out who did it, I'd say it would be much more interesting to find out why they did it.
Well, well, I see that word of your fame is more than just idle talk.
Father.
Brother Leonardo, running an abbey is no simple task. And in times like these, preserving the righteous faith of the community is even more difficult. Day by day, the people become less God-fearing, and the devil sows his seeds on the fertile soil of doubt and fear.
Are you trying to say that ignorance is a virtue?
Knowledge can be a devastating temptation, too. Especially at an abbey like ours. A fortress of wisdom and knowledge.
And like any fortress, it does have its cracks.
As you know, the archives of our library hold ancient and extremely rare copies of the most important writings of Christianity. Bibles, epistles from many saints, scriptures from significant blessed figures, written down to enhance the love of our Lord. It is our duty to preserve these precious books. And that's why access is denied to everyone except the librarian and his assistant.
Does that mean you think the gatekeeper's death points to the library?
There are rumors that strange things are going on in the library.
What kind of rumors?
The servants and common folk put faith in those kinds of superstition. They lack the necessary understanding to illuminate events concealed in the darkness of sin with the light of knowledge.
But it's obvious that we are presently not talking about rumors being spread by illiterates. What incidents?
Happenings of a supernatural nature. Who would doubt that a monastery is the best place to corrupt untainted souls? Perhaps evil is lurking like a predator after its prey.
And what do you think about that?
If a shepherd is told that a wolf is on the prowl, wouldn't he gather his flock and stand guard? Whatever I think is beside the point, but the monks are uneasy, and after Anselmo's death, all the more so.
So you want me to look into those rumors?
I'd like you to use your perceptive mind to find an explanation. As perceptive as you can be, and as discreetly as you can be.
Fair enough.
We thank you, Brother Leonardo.
But I will need something. I must be able to question the Brotherhood without restrictions.
As long as it doesn't disturb the Brothers' work, they will be glad to help you.
I thank you. Please exempt me from taking part at Mass.
In a battle like this, I'm not sure if you should make do without having the power of prayer at your side.
I am grateful for your concern, Father. But if there's one place at this monastery where I certainly won't find any demons, then it's the church.
All right. As you wish.
I need permission to enter the library.
But the rule is very strict with regard to this. No one is allowed to go.
If everything points to the library and strange things are happening, don't you think it could help me to find out the truth if I were allowed to go in there?
I am sure you'll find a way. Lucifer already roams freely about the abbey. There is no need for you to do so as well.
At the moment, it's not Lucifer who has me worried.
Brother Leonardo, this is Segundo, our prior.
Brother?
Brother Leonardo, the responsibility I bear demands that I not only keep the faith of this monastery, but that I safeguard its treasures too. The rules that forbid entry to the library serves that purpose, and I cannot permit people to walk in and out as if it were a marketplace.
But...
Your mission is to investigate the death of Anselmo the gatekeeper, and to find the signs of the devil in this matter.
Then please excuse me, Father. I have a job to do. There's a saying where I come from. If the prior makes merry, then what are the monks up to? Brother?
Listen well, brother. I ask you to please conclude your investigation as rapidly as possible. Because I'm not going to tolerate things like this at my abbey any longer. Was that sufficiently clear?
May I remind you that I stand under the abbot's command?
As do I. That's why I'm telling you.